morning, everyone. I thought I would just do a little chit-chat video today. I have another video ready, but I need to tweak some things to make it, you know, better for you. So first thing I'm going to show you is my morning ritual. I just filmed it, and this is just what I do every morning when I wake up. So, and I'm not going to do one of those fake videos where I'm stretching and getting out of bed with my makeup done. It's nothing like that. It's just something that I've been doing for a couple of weeks and I thought I would show you. So here goes. Hi everyone. I thought I would quickly show you my morning routine. Part of the things I do are for weight loss, part of them are for health, and part of them are just to have a special treat to start your day that is pretty low calorie. I drink coffee every morning. I like a donut shop coffee, and I get the Walmart brand, that's an old one, and put this in my Keurig. I'll close it in just a minute. What I wanted to show you is a month or 6 weeks ago, I did a video on putting milk in this jar and shaking it for 1 minute and warming it up, and it gave you some foam for your coffee, some foamed milk. Worked great. I showed it to Scott. He said I was crazy. He wasn't going to be walking around the kitchen shaking this thing, okay? So, another utensil that I had, or mechanism that I had to do this, which is inexpensive, five-ish dollars. You put your milk in your cup and you spin it with this little machine and it foams your milk. Well, Scott doesn't even really want to do that. The other thing was, he was wanting this like $300 coffee maker. It's called Scott? He's helping me film. He can't remember. Anyway, it's a very expensive coffee maker. And I said, if he could prove to me that he really wanted all this fancy stuff, then we would get it. But let's try this $28 item and see how that works. So I got for Christmas this thing called a NutriChef. Now, I couldn't find it on Amazon again, but they have the exact same thing, and it's called something else. But it's exactly like this. It comes in, at the time I ordered this one, it came in black and white. I'll try to link the same thing below, but I do believe they've changed the name. But it just sits here on this little electric heater thing. Now, the way this works is you can make hot milk without foam, cold foamy or hot foamy. I'm going to do hot foamy. You have this little thing that goes in there and you take part of it off to make just plain milk, just to heat your milk, okay? So, and that's the other that's the other thing you use just for the milk if you don't want it foamed. Okay, this is taking a long time, but in the morning it doesn't. I like to put my sweet and low in first because I like, when I drink my foam with my coffee, I like it to be sweet. So I'm adding milk just over that little mechanism that was down there, okay? This is 2% milk. I have found that that works the best. So all you do is put your milk in and you turn it on and it is now foaming and heating. All right, then I take my coffee cup and I start it brewing. Now it's gonna brew super slow, so I'm gonna talk about something else while it's doing that, because we don't know why it's so slow. We cleaned it, but I think I need to do some more cleaning. Okay, every morning for this is my second cup of coffee. My first cup of coffee, I put a teaspoon of coconut oil into the coffee before it brews. I just take this spoon, I dig it out of here, put it in, and then it melts it as it's brewing. This is supposed to curb your appetite some. I believe it's working, but what can I say? So I'm doing this for health and for possible weight loss because it's about to be shorts and beach time, you know, as much as I can get to a beach around here. Second thing I'm doing in the mornings after my coffee is Scott and I got this apple cider vinegar with the mother, and we have been drinking this every morning. 2 tablespoons. I do it in a little cup of water, and Scott just drinks it straight. I don't know how he stands it. I kind of use this, 2 of these. This is also supposed to aid for weight loss, health, digestion, all kind of things. So we'll see. We've been doing it for about how long? 2 weeks. He's not speaking. I don't know why. Okay, now I messed up because I stirred this with my spoon. So let me clean this off because I don't want this in my coffee. It's horrific. Although I don't, it doesn't really bother me. So I'll drink this later off camera. Okay, still waiting. Are you serious on this coffee? Okay, as you can see, the light's blinking, so that means it's finished. It takes maybe a minute, maybe a little less, I'm not sure. But you will see when I dump this into my coffee that it's a huge amount of foam compared to what you get with the shaking method or this method. And the foam lasts much, much longer than with those methods. Okay, so there's my coffee, and then I get this. And look at the foam in there, y'all. It's amazing. Okay, so I pour the milk. There's a little bit of milk left to you know, give milk in your coffee. And then I just let it kind of plop out. But it's so thick that you actually need to get a spoon. And it's just tons of foam. And the other thing is the foam lasts. So that's another benefit of having this little machine. Okay, it's thicker, see how it stands up. Now again, I got this in Paris, but I'm pretty sure you can get something like this. I'll look and see if I can leak something like this. This is cocoa powder and a little bit of some kind of sweetener that's powdery. And this is of course not necessary. So, I'll drink this, it'll have my first cup, I'll have my coconut oil in it. And you can taste the coconut, but it's not bad at all. It's just a little bit of flavor in it. And it's kind of good, actually. So here is to my new morning ritual. And now I'm going to go into my office, set up my camera, and show you my new hairdo. Okay, I'm back. And I hope you enjoyed that video. And I've still got my coffee here. I know that I didn't exactly show you very much how much foam. It was like this much in my cup. You know, it's because the coffee's only to about here. Anyway, it's a lot more foam than it looked like on that video. So my hair, I thought I would show y'all my new hair. Now, this is third. That was my mirror in case I wanted to check my hair, which I forgot to do anyway, so it doesn't matter that the mirror fell down. This is third day hair from the salon, but I love it. I don't know if you can tell that I've got some highlights in the lights. I have no idea if you can see. The sun is super bright today. Now outside you could definitely tell it, but I love the bangs. Oh, I've got to get my mirror. Hold on. Seriously, y'all, the mirror broke. Not the mirror, but the bottom of the mirror. Okay. When she was doing my hair, I asked her, now this is not a political statement, so please don't comment. But I went in and I told her, I said, I'm tired of my dark, all this so dark. I did have some balayage left down here, but I told her that I wanted kind of Melania Trump type highlights that she's had at different points of the years. Right now she's got more of a facial frame. And I asked her if she would just do a facial frame, and she said that that is going to bring so much attention that it's going to make my face look wider if I just kind of focus there. And I said, no, because I already have this giant square face. And so anyway, she just did a light all over highlights. They're not going to show much when they grow out. I don't know how much maintenance they're going to be. I don't care. I needed some sun in my life. Sunshine. You know, I just went to Florida. So this is my Florida hair while I'm living in Texas. And I really love it. Now, the bangs. OMG. Okay. She's blow drying my hair, you know. And she stops just for a second and I look in the mirror and my bangs are kind of like this. I don't know what they look like right now. Yeah. My bangs are kind of like this. And right before she turned the blow dryer back on, I went, oh. How did you get my bangs to look like this? And she said, I haven't done anything to them yet. That's just from the wind. And I said, don't touch them. And she said, okay, great. So they're to the side. And I like that a lot. But the other thing, if you look at Melania Trump photos, when she does have bangs, she doesn't have bangs right now. They're down, like, and kind of long. But when she did have bangs years ago, they were kind of PC. Where my bangs have been more like, you know, Zooey Deschanel bangs, you know, all the way across, solid. And I was kind of tired of that. Well, I can also make these straight across. Let me see if I can do it. I can do these straight across, and they're just lightened up. And what she did is she cut little triangles into the bottom. That's hair talk from me, not from her. She just cut little triangles in the bottom so that I can still do this and not have it so heavy. And I know that this mirror is showing, and it's filthy fingerprinting on the back. But I kind of like this for a change. Now, the problem with this is now my eyebrows show, y'all. I don't even know. But I did as best as I could. I did as well as I could today with my eyebrows in 2 seconds. Okay, other things I wanted to share, just chit-chatting, right? Okay, remember my video that I did not long ago? So excited with this thing where I had all my house stuff in here. Different, if you didn't watch that video, I'll link it. But it was a great video showing how I plan to design, as I'm designing a home, the different things that I do and that I just cut out of magazines and catalogs and make collages, okay? That's what this is about. Well, of course, when I got home from Florida, dreaming of Florida, I'm telling you, I'm going back at some point. I may not be still on YouTube by then, but you know, do you hear how I say all my sentences backwards? I may not still be. I may still not be. Anyway, I don't even know how to say it. I might not be on YouTube by the time I get back to Florida, but you never know what might happen. And so, of course, my whole life has changed. I'm going back to Florida 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 years. But I want to be ready, right? So I have made the most fabulous Pinterest board called, I think it's called Beach Cottage Dreams. And by beach cottage, I don't mean on the beach. That's kind of for the wealthy, as far as I'm concerned. We can't afford to be on the beach. Plus, there's insurance, taxes, out of control. But I'm going to call it a beach cottage as long as I'm within 30 minutes of the beach. That's what I'm going to call it. So it says Beach Cottage Dreams. And it's kind of like when you take a house and you redo it. Who knows? We are not redoers. We are brand new buyers, usually. Ask my mom. She always says, I've never seen a person have so many brand new houses as you do. All right. So, to keep myself in my Florida mode for the next 5 years, I've been obsessed. Okay, I keep my map out. I keep my Florida map out, which I found when I cleaned out the Saturn. So I know that we want to be here in Central Florida, somewhere along that coast, the West Coast of Florida. I always mix those up. So I keep my map around. But what I've been doing, too, is gathering magazines that I can use to start a decorating notebook 2.0. Right in the middle where I left off, I'm gonna start beach things. So I thought I'd show you a few things that I've gotten to use. I've got a new Grandin Road catalog, and it's just full of beautiful, y'all, I'm dying for this picture. Tell me what you think if it's not glary. Look at that, is that not so peaceful and gorgeous? I absolutely love it. I hope you can see that. Can you see it? Okay. Love. Okay. Anyway, lots of fun stuff in here. Always an Anthropology catalog can inspire you to the limits, to unlimited. I mean, I do not have a command of the English language this morning. Anyway, lots of fun stuff in here. Just stunning. Oh, let me show you this pillow, y'all. To die. Look at that pillow. See, this marries together my glam that I was going to do in this house. I kind of put that on hold. But this is that gold where it's got glam, and then the blue and white that I love that can also be beachy. And look at these dishes. I mean, are you serious, y'all? It's just beautiful. So I'm going to be cutting this thing to death. All right. While I was at my mother-in-law's house last weekend in San Antonio, she takes coastal living. And I used to take it when I lived in Florida, but it was too depressing to take while I was living in Houston. I just couldn't do it. I just had to cancel. I can't take it. I can't. Well, I'm in her house and I see these coastal living magazines. I'm thinking, I'm going to start. This is after Florida. I said, I'm going to start subscribing to that again. Okay. So she let me have her last two issues. the last two issues, okay? So I'm going through these, going crazy. So many beautiful ideas and just inspiration again. I will be cutting these up. I know that sounds terrible, but first I'm going to read them from cover to cover. And if there's an article or something, I might have to start an article notebook. Places to visit when I get back to Florida. Or just beaches to visit around the whole world. That's what these are about. So I'm subscribing to that again. So that'll be fun. But I have two issues for now to deal with. Now, I don't know if I told y'all about this, but this magazine, y'all, is so good. You know, I'm so tired of magazines that are all ads and stuff. This magazine tends to have more in it. I subscribe to it. I gave my mom a subscription, and she loves it, and I love it. I may have already talked about this, but it's the HGTV magazine. Now, I will say, there's way too much color in this magazine every month for me because I don't like a lot of color, but it still has great ideas. It's great design. I love the before and afters that they do, like an old kitchen. You know, that's kind of what's gotten her thinking. Maybe we'll get us a, I already told you that, an old house that needs renovating. Anyway, so that's the situation. HGTV, great magazine. The other thing I have here, which is so crazy, when we were in Sarasota, we went around the circle, you know, at St. Armand's Circle, and we looked at lots of available properties. I mean, I don't know why we're doing that, but it's fun. I even have a realtor. I told her I don't have a timeline. She probably thinks I mean 2 or 3 months. What I mean is 2 or 3 years, 4 or 5, 6. I don't know. Anyway, this is what is motivating me and exciting me. And y'all, listen, I have not gotten back to either one of my books since Christmas. And I need someone to motivate me in the comments and tell me to finish my book, get the other one edited. And because I told you I want them both in on Amazon by the end of this year. So I'm dragging my feet and I don't know why, but my second book of course takes place in the Florida Keys, and so I did get motivated in Florida, so I've just got to sit down and commit to keeping the story going, because right now the people are just, they're just floating out there in beach land, and they don't have anywhere to go, they don't know what's going to happen to them, and I don't either, that's part of the problem. So anyway, okay, how's that for a chatting video? I don't know what you think, but that's it for today, and I'll talk to you later. Bye!